Hey dads, are you looking for a top of the line Sony camcorder that you can use? I've got one here that the company that I worked for let me use, so I figured that I would talk to you about it. I've actually used it a few times now, and it's really nice, it's just really big, but we'll get into that in just a minute. First of all, hi to all the new dads out there. This is Dad Reviews. This is where I give you my unedited, hopefully more authentic review of the products that I like, use, and have, and people let me borrow. So if you're into that, you might want to consider clicking that subscribe button. Also, that thumbs up button is very much appreciated. So this, to get the exact model number, is the Sony Handycam HDR-AX2000 Handycam camcorder by Sony. And I really like it. You know, it's definitely big. It's got some bulk to it, but there's a lot of settings and extra special features and whatnot that you can put onto here. First of all, I wanted to talk to you guys about the different settings that you can set the video modes to. So you can do 1080 at 60 frames per second interlaced, and then 1080 at 30 frames per second progressive, and then they also do 1080 at 24 frames per second, 24p, and then it also does some SD settings, which is 480 60i, 480 30p scan, and 480 24p scan, and you do that just by setting it in the menu there. Now, what comes with this Sony cam whenever you buy it is you get the power cord, which is this little guy right here. It comes into the power adapter thing, and then the cord that just plugs into the wall right there. To charge the battery, you have to do it in camera, and you have your battery on the back here, and then you have your port. This little door opens right here, and that's where you plug in the power adapter right there so that you can charge the battery. Now, the battery does not charge while recording. You actually have to put it onto the off mode, which you change your modes right here. You have on and off. Whenever it's off and the charger is plugged in, then it'll actually charge the battery. So something that you should make note of, being that you can't charge and film at the same time. Whenever it comes to the little view display here, you get a little flip out screen here, which is really nice. Just to give you an idea of angles, it only goes to the top. It doesn't flip all the way around, but unless you go from the bottom, then it'll flip all the way so that you can see it. If you're holding it up like this, you'll be able to see what you're filming. So one way it goes almost all the way, and then this way it goes all the way. So there's only that, let's see, if it goes there all the way. Yeah, so you get full 360. You just have to remember that you can't make it, you know, you can't turn it all the way this way. Wait, you can. No, that way you can't turn it all the way. Just a nice little HD screen that does shoot AVC HD on there. You do have some XLR inputs right here. You got a right channel and a left channel right there. And you can control, let me open this door up right here. You can control the levels of those microphones right here, but you need to make sure that you put it on input 1 and input 2 to be able to use the XLRs. If you don't, it's going to use the internal microphone that's built into this camcorder. On this lens here, it does have a focus ring and a zoom ring right there, so you can use manual controls there if you like. There's a lens door open right there to keep your lens clean. The little switch is right here on the side of the cover here, which this is another piece that comes, it's removable. You can detach it and unattach it. Same thing with the eyepiece here. This whole thing, this whole rubber eyepiece comes off so that, you know, it's kind of a blackout screen type of thing. Let's see, there's also a wireless remote that comes with it that the company, I didn't see it in the bag that they gave me. There's a few like component video cables and AV cables that come with it, a USB cable. The battery and then the lens cover. There's also a CD-ROM thing that comes with it too. I'm just looking at the instruction manual here and showing you guys what all actually came with the camera. Now, one thing that I really like about this camera on the first project that I did with this same company is the slow-mo features of it. It's got this really nice slow-mo action that you can do with it. And basically what I was doing is I was filming a house, and they kind of wanted almost like a gliding effect. And the way it looked, whenever I got done with the slow-mo, it just looked really, really amazing. Nice, crisp picture. I really, really like it. It definitely does have that video feel because it is a camcorder, and you have to be able to zoom in really far and then focus on whatever you want to focus on the foreground to give it that depth of field if that's what you're going for. But as far as just like turning it on and shooting with it with no zoom, you're not gonna get that depth of field that you want. They do have a mount on the top here if you wanted to mount a light or a different mic or something like that. It does have a shoe right there. There's three settings of an ND filter here if you wanna use your ND filter. There is an expanded focus button right here that you can use to expand your focus as well. There are two places to do zooming, or actually three places. You have a slider right here, right above where your hand goes into the grip. Then if you're holding it from up top here, there's also a zoom right here. There's also a start and stop record button right there as well. On the back here is your main start stop, and your this is where it turns on and off, which I already showed you. And then the third zoom is the one that I already showed you guys, the ring here on the lens. This is a 20 times optical zoom right there, as you can see. And I can get pretty far. I was standing in the, for the second project that I did with them, I was standing in the back of the room, pretty large ballroom, on a riser, and I was able to zoom in all the way up to the podium just perfectly, and the picture looked great even after the zoom. It didn't get digitized because it's an optical zoom and not a digital zoom. They do have some different modes that you can set here. I guess you can create your own. I did not play around with this at all, I'll say. I don't know if these are preset because they do have some stuff written on top of there like your zebra and whatnot. But I know, I'm pretty sure these are like manual setting things that you can set there. This camera does have a ton of buttons on here to be able to have more manual control over everything on here, from your gain to your white balance, shutter speed, and everything on there. Whenever I used it, I didn't want to screw up anything with the video, so I just left mostly everything on a manual, an automatic focus here. To scroll through the menu, which I had to do because I needed to set the microphone, I believe it was. They do have this little wheel right here, and then you can select on the side here, and then also the wheel makes you go up and down. This is side to side, and then you push in the wheel whenever you want to click a certain setting, for lack of a better word. It does have a spot on the bottom here to put a shoe for a tripod if you want to add a tripod to it. This, actually, the tripod that they let me borrow, which, here, I'll go ahead and show it to you guys. I plan on doing another review of it, too. This guy right here, it's pretty hefty, but it has this remote cord that you can connect to it. So this tripod has a remote on, off, and zoom that connects right here onto the camera. So it's fairly out of the way, you know, it's coming back this way, especially if you're holding it like this. It shouldn't get in the way too much of where your hand is so that you can use your buttons. Your memory cards, it does have a slot for two memory cards here, which is nice because if you have two smaller memory cards, that could equal up to be a lot and you'll have enough. But you just pop in some SD memory cards into there, or a micro SD card with an adapter onto there. The ones that they use is this guy right here. I'll link that up down in the description below. It's just a SanDisk, let's see, how fast is that? 45 megabytes per second, class 10, 32 gig. Should give you about 8 hours of footage, although it doesn't say what you're shooting at, so it doesn't, that doesn't, it says 8 hour. That doesn't make any sense. Whoops. I'll leave that right there. There's the battery release button is right here, just right above the battery. Press that in, push it up, comes out. If you want to put it onto a dock there. They do have some outputs right here. Outputs, component, audio, video. Looks like a USB there. I'm trying to read it backwards. HDMI component, there's a USB, and then there's also just your regular AV cords right there, for lack of a better term. I believe the USB, you can connect to HDMI and USB, you can connect to different monitors, playback decks, and whatnot, so you can have more control and viewing screens over there. There is a place to put in headphones, because there's a headphone monitor. You can monitor just the right channel, the left channel, or both in stereo. Let's see, I know I had them in. Where's the headphone jack? Right here. Your headphone jack is right here. Nice and out of the way, which I like. just kind of comes to the back. I kind of wish that this little nougat right here that holds the thing in was on the other side. That way it wouldn't be held back with the plug going this way. Although I guess it could go down as well, because most of the time the headphones hang down. But it's just one little thing that I noticed. You know, if you have those 90 degree headphones and you're plugging it in right there, you're gonna kind of always be pulling back on this, just giving a little bit of wear and tear to that little nougat right there. So, one small thing that I wish they'd change. By the way, if you guys want to check this out, I'm going to link it up down in the description below. You guys, I'm sure there's plenty of other reviews that you guys can read over on Amazon down in the review section there. If you guys have ever used this camera before or a camera like it, or if you have any experience with this, I would definitely love to know about it down in the comments below, because some of the best information comes from you guys, and I learned so much from you guys down in the comments below, and we kind of come together as a community of dads down there to figure out, you know, what's best for our needs. Because someone who's making YouTube videos definitely doesn't need this. But if they're doing more high-end production, they might want to look into something like this. So I'd be curious to know what y'all's experience is with that. And if y'all know anything else about this camera that I didn't touch on in this video, you can let me know that down in the comments below. And again, we'll come together. If you guys want to watch more videos from us, I'm going to put more videos right there on the screen. I'd love it if you guys watch more of our videos. Make sure to click that subscribe button right there in the middle if you're liking what we're doing here on Dad Reviews. If, like I said, this is going to be linked up down in the description below. I'd love it if you guys went and read more reviews, at least get the knowledge that you need to make a smart buying decision. Thank you guys for watching, and Dad out.